quite amazing to see the sun peeking up over the mountain like that.
You know, the way the sun hits the mountains and shades part of them, and that changes, you know, as the sunrise comes up. It's very majestic.
As far as jobs go, this is pretty amazing. I mean, getting to work out here in these canyons and mountains, and it's all very beautiful, the way it all comes together. The varied topography of the area is quite amazing.
My name is Travis Smith.
My name is Will Rhodes. I used to live in the city and got tired of that pretty quick. Found that this is just really where I fit in.
Just a different way of life out here, and I love it.
This is Black Cap Wildlife Management Area. We're in southern Brewster County, which is in the Trans-Pecos region of Texas.
We're in the Chihuahuan Desert ecosystem. The area is 103,000 acres, or a little over. Black Gap's kind of in the middle of nowhere. You know, it's 55 miles from the closest town. There are only four individuals that live on the area.
To the nearest Walmart's 110 miles, and even there, there's not many people there. At night, you know, you get the full stars, everything. You see the entire Milky Way. Whereas in the city, you might be able to see a couple stars.
My wife's a very understanding woman. She actually loves it just as much as I do out here.
Just by its definition, this is a wildlife management area, so we have to manage and maintain the wildlife for the people of Texas. We have close to 300 miles of roads that all need to be maintained.
Yeah, with just the two of us, there's very little downtime, and you know, we don't get bored very often. As we all know, animals need water. Our annual rainfall is only around 11 inches a year, so we're trying to supplement that water during dry periods. A guzzler is a rain catchment. Water will be collected, funneled into a tank, which then feeds a water trough for wildlife. We have 45 guzzlers on the area that we maintain. We like to periodically check them to make sure everything's in working order. Make sure the wind or animals haven't walked on the catchment and bent it, or the wind is loosening it. Just make sure everything's in good working order to provide water for wildlife.
With it just being me and Travis out here, it would be nearly impossible to get all this work done without the support and funds from Mule Deer Foundation, Texas Bighorn Society, and Wildlife and Sport Fish Restoration Fund. So this catchment consists of our panel in 12-foot lengths, which is connected to these 6-inch sea purlings by
a 5/16-inch bolt head with a 14 by 7/8 pitch thread, which is then welded onto these 2-inch square tubings. This all leads to a 4-inch gutter into a 4-inch drainage pipe, which leads into a 2,500-gallon storage tank. On 1-inch rain, this should, in theory, catch 400 gallons of water.
And that right there is a rain guzzler.
We have a lot of tools as biologists, but one of the most unique ones are game cameras. A game camera is a camera we can set over basically anywhere. We like to focus on water sources, since that's where animals come to congregate.
On these game cameras, it's triggered by motion. Usually that's going to be wildlife coming in to get water from the guzzlers here. And game cameras also have infrared illuminators, so we can get video and photographs even in pitch black. We wait 2 weeks before collecting images from the cameras. We just have to be patient.
It's a very relaxing commute to the office in the mornings. You know, it's just a stone throws away from my house. You know, no fighting traffic or road rage.
All right, these are the ones we pulled from the camera today. Should be about 2 weeks worth of data.
All right, now we're getting some deer.
Yeah. Does here.
Four does, yeah. And that's one collared one, or a ear
tagged. Yeah, there she is.
Yeah, there's the ear tags. They look very healthy, good shape.
A little buck here.
A decent little buck. If you go back, you can get kind of an age, you know. He's not too young. Got a little bit of a Roman nose there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say that's a typical buck that you'd find on Black Gap. Oh, got a little coyote.
Yeah, it's a young one.
Oh, we're seeing what you would expect down here, you know, coyotes and mule deer. A lot of javelina. That's probably your most common thing on the cameras.
Some collared mule deer go into these waters, and that helps with determining movements of wildlife as well. Even hawks and buzzards will benefit from these water sources. Really, every animal on the area is going to benefit from this water.
Hey, this is one of our new game cameras that's set up on one of the water troughs that's on the guzzler here. Get the files off and see what's been visiting this guzzler. These are all going to be videos. All right, from all these videos, we can see it's quite impressive the amount of wildlife and diversity of the wildlife coming to this new guzzler. Looks like we have several mule deer, along with some of our collared release does from earlier this year. We got some gray fox. It's like a whole lot of javelina, as was expected. That tells us that it has been effective in what we wanted it to do. Time takes on a different feel out here.
I love this area of Texas. I love the mountainous region mixed in with the Chihuahuan desert.
Not every person can be this isolated and this happy. This is God's country.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Wildlife Restoration Program.